kicked a couple up on Rock's backhand. He kicked one into his forehand and blew some smoke down on him at set point, and he now leads two sets to love Rod Laver to start the third set. Laver has started serving in each set. He's a champion, but Harry, you've seen him down. He's really down now. Until the final point is called against him. He also has the uncanny knack of pulling off some big shots at the right time. Just jumps on it by Hugh Stewart, who has just signed up to be the resident pro at punching the ball here at Caesars Palace. At least make that
right. I beat you. Don't beat yourself.
Get it back. The backhand volley in the open court. I think Laver might try to go up the middle with this one. Connors is sliding over for the wide one. Okay, here's four motions. Laver serves nice deep ball. Half volley.
15.
Connors is down the line. Rock stabs for it. A very easy shot. Connors comes right back to him, and Laver with reflexes knocks it at Connors, who misses. Back line. 3-15. Kicks the ball up to Laver's back in. A short return. Connors doesn't come in. Laver says, I'll come in. Down the line like a bullet. Laver makes the volley in an angled cross court forehand volley for a winner. There's the great Joe Louis, the champ. Yeah. The champ is right. In my opinion, the greatest heavyweight of all time. And even Howard Cosell's here. And when Connors lost to John Newcomb in the finals of the Australian Open recently, I thought one of the things that helped Nuke was the ability to change pace and change the spins and speeds a little bit. Rod is trying to do a little bit of that itself. Connors made a short approach shot. He had it about 4 feet from the baseline.
I didn't talk to get in here.
Comes on a pretty deep shot, anticipated the cross court.